Well, hello YouTube. This is Rich again from Rich Micro Tooling Technologies. And today I'm going to try to make something very economical. My GoPro, which is filming right now, I've never had something that I could just hold it in my hand. Yes, I can buy it. We all can buy things. This is a little bit of ingenuity. Let's get our minds working on this. Get a little hold on what we want to do. Very economical part. PVC pipe, an end cap, and a piece of Delrin. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut this off here to probably right around 7-inch mark. All right, so we're going to cut it off. Eventually, the plug's going to go to here. This plug, which I have to turn down and thread, is going to go inside. Because if you have a GoPro, like I do, and probably most of YouTube is filming as we speak, it's got a 1/4-20 screw through it, and that'll screw onto one of your mounts. And that's what I plan to do, is once I do drill and tap it, it's probably going to stick up probably like 3/16 of an inch, somewhere in that fashion. Haven't really decided what I want to do. I got a whole bunch of set screws. I may end up doing a set screw, putting it down inside of there, and somehow I'll fuse it in there somehow, some way. And what I'm going to do is, this is just going to end up being a press fit. So I'm going to put a slight chamfer, like the chamfer you see right there. I don't know if it's that easy to see, especially with the there. Sun's coming into the shop here, so I hope you can see that. All right. So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to press, once it's turned down, drilled, and tapped, down inside of here. And again, the end cap's going to be there. And what that's going to do is, I don't even know what it's called, but me and the wife were going to be taking a vacation, long deserved vacation. And I want to try to get, we're going on a new ship. It's a cruise. And I just would like to walk around and maybe get a little bit of footage that some people just don't see on the ship. All right. Okay. So what I did was I shortened up my plug. It was a little too long. So this, the internal here, of course, PVC, it's not going to be perfectly round. It's not a bore. I'm not going to worry about trying to bore it out. And I'm getting anywheres from 696 to 709. I'm going to shoot for about 705, and that should give us our press fit. So stay tuned, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you over to the lathe, and we're going to go through this, okay? All right, see you in a couple seconds. Okay, so we got you set up in the lathe. I hope you got a good shot. It's a new, I just had to do a battery change. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring half the diameter down to the 705. Imagine we're starting right around the 3/4 mark. We are. 702. Alright, let's get cutting tool in here. Okay, just a touch off. I'm going to go into high gear because we're cutting plastic. Or Delrin. And again, let's take another look at this real quick. 702 is what I'm coming up with. 752, I'm sorry. So, let's take a just to see where we're at. So we're at 738. Let's do another 10. 717. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a grand total of 10. I'm going to do 5 on my dial. Check here real quick. And 707. I'll take it. I will take it. Okay, so I'm gonna switch out my tooling. Gonna face it. And we're gonna put a nice chamfer on that. So at first I had said I wasn't really sure what I was going to do. So now I've made the decision. I am going to take just a little chamfer on there. It didn't clean up all that good. Well, we're going to go back and redo this. Actually, I might have to turn you off and go touch up that tool. All right, that's what I'll do. Okay, well, we're back. Let's take a... I took and I sharpened it up and I honed the edge on it. Let's see if we get anything better on this one. Okay, much better finish on that. All right, so now this is going to be, since we have it here, we've already got it trued, we're going to take and we're going to drill and tap it for the quarter 20. So I decided I am not going to go through with this, and I'll tell you why. I'm wondering if this could possibly aid as a flotation device, if it ever fell overboard, you know, on a kayak trip or whatever. With the airspace that's in that 7 inches of airspace, I'm not gonna do the calculation. What I'll probably end up doing is filling up the sink, putting it in and seeing if it sinks or swims. Right, that's where you learn how to swim, isn't it? Okay, 201 on the drill. And 201. You know what? This is a good practice for everyone to do. I've been burned before in the shop. Not this shop, but my old job. 201 is our drill size for quarter 20 screw. 201 it was. I picked up drills out of the index thinking it's 201 or it's a F drill or whatever, and come to find out that, oh no, it's not even close. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill a grand total of, let's get my set screws out here. Like I said, told you all I had a shit ton of quarter 20 screws, right? Yeah. And I may not even use steel. I may end up using plastic. I have some plastic. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in 1/2 inch. Now remember, we're doing plastic. Sorry. There we go. My wife, I'll call her back. Okay, so now I'm just going to tap that through. And I'm going to use the power feed. Slow rate. Putting in a real crappy bottom tap. So why a crappy bottom tap? Well, the crappier the threads are going to be on that, what I'm hoping for is it'll lock the set screw in. Okay, so we're just going to float on the tailstock. Actually, you know something? By the time I get done reversing it and everything, it's just going to be a pain in the ass. So I'll tell you what, this is what I'm going to do on this. I'm just going to release the chuck and back it right up. Okay? That's going to be coming out of there anyway. So let me get my... Okay, now, I don't know if you could see, there's a lot of resistance off that thread. Sort of what I'm hoping to find. And when I say about locking that set screw in, I mean so that while you unscrew the camera off of it, little noise. It's not going to back out on you, okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip this around. I know it's probably not going to run real super true, but what I want to do is I want to bring this down right around to the same dimension, if not just a little bit smaller. We'll go back up into high. Let's take a look at this. Better. I've seen better, but it's not bad. For our application, this is going to be just fine. Remember, we were at 707 on our last dimension on the other side of the plug. And I got 37. Another 10. That should take us to the 17. It is. And now we're going to take the 10, which is 5 on my dial. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to do 4/1000ths. Like maybe about 1/4 of an inch. That'll help me get started, engaged into the PVC pipe. Good there. Back that off. We'll change out our tooling. Let's get a nice chamfer on that. So there we have it. There's our quarter 20. It's hard to see the dimension. What I should have done is I should have blacked it out for you so that you're able to follow that out. And if I do opt, which I probably will, it seems. Actually, this might not have to be trimmed down itself. Okay, which it will. But that's what it's going to look like. And the mount that I have in question, it's very shallow, maybe a quarter of an inch, and I don't even know if you're going to get the full thread on that, which I have various sizes here. I can mix and match, I can play around. Okay, so basically, this is what we're looking for, is that. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the PVC. And I'll bring you back in just 1 second. All right, so we are done with the project. Yeah, I'm sorry, I went ahead and I just pressed it in. It was easy to do. Like I said, I had that about a quarter inch of a lead in there. I just stuck it down inside of the pipe. It stuck real nice. I flipped it over on my aluminum plate. Boom, hit it. And it sunk right in. I brought the set screw down to size to where I wanted it to be. And then once I got the plug in and I fit the screw, then I came to the backside. And I cleaned up the pipe. And I went through with the PVC cleaner, Oatly, and then with the rubber cement, and I just cemented that in. I don't know how much of a flotation device that'll be. I really don't know. I mean, it might help float the camera. I mean, it might be ass up like that. I'm really not sure. But if it happens. Okay, so then here's the mount that we were talking about. And that I use a lot. Or like on my helmet and so on and so forth. But anyways, we're going to put it together. Alright, so there you go. I don't know if you can see, there's no gap in between there. It seats real nice. And so I'm going to have a nice handheld mount when I go around the ship. Or on the trail or wherever I am. And hopefully, like I say, maybe we'll have a nice airtight seal on that. I'm going to give it a float test here in a while, and hopefully it will. If not, that's really not really the main reason. I can always wrap a lanyard around there and have it on my hand. All right, folks. Well, thanks for joining me. I know it's not my normal metalworking thing, but it's something that I've been wanting to do for a while. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Hit the like button for it if you want. I've never seen anything like this made before, so I don't know if I'm the first. Make some chips. Be happy. All right, folks. I'm out.